If you look in the top of the corner of your tabs in Firefox, they appear slightly other places in some other browsers, you'll see that each tab has an icon. These are called favicons, and you can create one for your own website. Now, if you prefer and you have Photoshop or Illustrator, you can do something in Photoshop or Illustrator, or here you can just draw one. So I'm going to draw a very simple favicon for myself. And it would be very easy for me to take a lot of time doing this, which I am simply not going to do. Because I don't think you want to watch me. So I'm basically just doing my initials, which generally turns out pretty well as a favicon. So this is really simple. It's not the greatest, but it works. So I'm going to, and this shows you what it'll look like, I'm going to download my favicon. And I'm going to move it . Actually, I can just get that directly from my downloads. So I'm going to go into Firefox, and I'm going to connect to WEB-105, and I'm going to go to my downloads, and I'm going to take it and put it in the top level of my public HTML. Now it's going to take a while for it to show up, probably, because even though you can force a page to refresh, it doesn't necessarily. Oh, it did. It showed up right away. It doesn't always do that, but that's where it'll show up. If it doesn't show up right away, that's normal. Just try it from a different browser and you should see it right away. Or if you need to, try it from a different computer. So while that's not a great favicon compared to these, and I would encourage you to take more time and make a prettier favicon, that's how you do it. That's how you get those little icons up there. And so that's what I want you to do. And I encourage you, if you have artistic skill, go ahead and use Photoshop or Illustrator. You want to use a square. It's going to come down to like 16 by 16 pixels, so keep it simple. But create a favicon, add it to your page, and just hand in the link to your index page so I can see your favicon.